This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about triangle congruence and why side-side angle congruence doesn't always work. So let's get started. You know when you've got two triangles and you want to show that they're congruent, there are a number of different ways you can do this. You might use side-side-side congruence or side-angle-side or angle-side-angle or angle-angle-side. What about side-side angle? Let's see if that's a possibility. What I've done is I've drawn two angles. They're congruent angles. For each of the angles, one of the sides is a ray, so it hasn't got a specific length. And for each of the angles, one of the sides is a line segment, so it's got a specific length, and those line segments are congruent. And now I'm going to try to form two triangles. I'm going to do this with two sticks that are the same length, so they would be congruent sides. Let's see what happens. I can form a triangle here. And I can form the same triangle at the other angle, so I can form two congruent triangles. The problem is this. There's another kind of triangle I can form. I can swing one of these sticks around and form a triangle which is very different from the other triangle. So what this means is I've got a pair of congruent sides. That was the sticks that I used. I've got another pair of congruent sides. Those were the sides that I drew in. And I've got a pair of congruent angles. But I don't have a pair of congruent triangles. So in this case, side-side angle didn't work as a way to prove congruency. Now, notice that in this case, I had an acute angle. Let's see what happens if I have an obtuse angle. So I've drawn an obtuse angle. One side of the angle is a ray, and one side is a line segment. And I'm going to take this stick and see how many different triangles I can form. And it looks like, no matter how I move the stick, there's really only one place, one way, that I can form a triangle. So that means that when my angle is an obtuse angle, when it's greater than 90 degrees, then side-side angle will work. Okay? Will not work for an acute angle. It will work for an obtuse angle. It will also work for a right angle. Let's look at that. So I've got a right angle. One side of the angle is a ray. The other side is a line segment. And I can use a stick to form the third side. And there's only one way I can form that third side. So this will work also. In other words, if I have a right angle, it will work. If I have an obtuse angle, it will work. It won't work with an acute angle. When I have a right angle, instead of saying angle side-side angle, sometimes you'll see this referred to as just HL for hypotenuse leg. Because when you've got a right angle, the side opposite that angle is the hypotenuse. The sides next to the angle are called legs. So if you've got hypotenuse leg as a kind of congruency with a right angle, then you know you've got two congruent triangles also. Okay, so right angle will work. We refer to that as HL. Other than that, you can use side-side angle, but be careful. You've got to have an obtuse angle. If the angle is acute, then you can't prove the two triangles are congruent. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.